So, dear students, today we are going to see some important theorems in the chapter cone. So, first we are going to find the condition for the given equation f of x comma y comma z to represent a cone. If it represents a cone, we have to show that the first order partial derivatives of f with respect to x, y, z, t, where t is used to make f of x comma y homogeneous and is equated to unity after differentiation. So we have to prove the first order partial differential equation of f with respect to x, y, z, t will be equal to zero. And here they have given that what is t and what is its characterization. So to solve this, I have given some tips. First, we have to shift the vertex to the origin. Second, through the first order partial derivatives with respect to x, y, z, t are zero. Third, by combining all the equations, we are going to find the condition to represent a cone. So we have taken the given equation as equation number one. That is f of x comma y comma z is equal to ax square plus by square plus cz square plus 2fyz plus 2gzx plus 2hxy plus 2ux plus 2vy plus 2wz plus b is equal to 0. First, we have to take a common vertex alpha comma beta comma gamma. So we are shifting equation 1 to the vertex alpha comma beta comma gamma. So instead of x, we will put x plus alpha the whole square. Instead of y, we put y plus beta, and z, we put z plus gamma. Here, we have expand the given equation. X plus alpha square is equal to x square plus alpha square plus 2x alpha. Similarly for y plus beta the whole square, similarly for z plus gamma the whole square, and the product of y plus beta and z plus gamma, that is yz, y gamma, beta z and beta gamma. Similar mechanism is worked out, and now we are combining the equation 2 and equation 1. We are equating the terms. So now we are taking the second equation. If it represents a cone, then coefficient of x in the above equation, we have taken the coefficient of x here, it's 2a alpha, and here x is 2gz, here 2hy, and here 2g gamma, and here 2h beta, and 2u. So combining this, we will get 2a alpha, 2h beta, 2g gamma plus 2u equal to 0. So we will take that equation number 3. So first equation implies dou f by dou x is equal to 2ax plus 2hy plus 2gz plus 2u. If we are substituting the vertex as alpha, beta, gamma, instead of x we will put alpha, y we put beta, z we put gamma. So the answer will be this 2a alpha, 2h beta, 2g gamma plus 2u. But by the above equation, the answer will be equal to 0. That is dou f by dou x in alpha, beta, gamma will be equal to 0. Similarly, we can prove that dou f by dou y, dou f by dou z at the point alpha, beta, gamma equal to 0. So now we are introducing t. We are using the parametric substitution for the cone with center and radius u, v, w and d instead of u, we will put ut. V, we will put vt, and w, we are using wt. Instead of d, we are using dt square. And maintain homogeneity, t is equated to 1 after differentiation. This is given in the problem. So 1 implies so this is equation number 1, ax square plus by square plus cz square plus 2fyz plus 2gzx plus 2hxy plus 2ux plus 2vy plus 2wz plus d is equal to 0. And using this, in this equation, we have substitute the given parametric substitutions. So after differentiating with respect to t, we will get 2ux, 2vy, 2wz plus 2d. So to maintain homogeneity, t is equated to 1 after differentiation. So instead of t, we will put 1. So the answer will be 2ux, 2vy, 2wz plus 2d. And we are substituting the vertex alpha, beta, gamma into this, and we will get this answer. Instead of x, alpha, instead of y, beta, instead of z, gamma. And now we are going to prove this will be equal to 0. And we have taken that as equation number 5. So we are equating the constant terms in equation number 2. We will get this. These are the entire constant terms in equation 2, and right side it will be equal to 0. Now we are taking alpha, beta, gamma from their responding terms, and the other terms will be u alpha, v beta, w gamma plus d. And we know that by equation 4, these 3 will be 0. And by dou f by dou x is equal to 0, which means 2a alpha, 2h beta, 2g gamma plus 2u equal to 0. If we divide the entire equation by 2, we will get that a alpha plus h beta plus g gamma plus 2u is equal to 0. So by substituting these 3, we will get this is equal to 0, that is u alpha, v beta, w gamma plus d is equal to 0. By equation 5, dou f by dou t at the point alpha, beta, gamma is nothing but 2u alpha, 2v beta, 2w gamma plus 2d. If you are taking 2 as common, you will get the answer will be 0. So from all the above conditions, we have proved this. If these conditions are true, then the given equation will represent a cone. Now we have taken these 4 equations. Here alpha, beta, gamma are the variables. So by eliminating alpha, beta, gamma from the above 4 equations, we can get the condition for equation 1 represent a cone. So we are using the determinant method. So from this, we have taken all the coefficients a, h, g, u, h, b, f, v, g, f, c, w, u, v, w, and d is equal to 0. And this is the condition for equation number 1 to represent a cone. So now we can see an example. So we are going to prove that x square minus 2y square plus 3z minus 4xy plus 5yz minus 6zx plus 8x minus 19y minus 2z minus 20 is equal to 0 represent a cone with vertex 1, minus 2, 3. So first we are going to find the partial derivatives. Dou f by dou x is equal to 2x minus 4y minus 6z plus 8. So at alpha, beta, gamma, it will be 2 alpha minus 4 beta minus 6 gamma plus 8. Here, instead of alpha, we are having 1. Instead of beta, we are having minus 2. Instead of gamma, it's 3. That is, instead of x, y, z, we are going to substitute this equation, this point, and we will get 0. Similarly, dou f by dou y and dou f by dou z will be 0. Next, we are going to use t such that instead of u, we will use ut. Instead of v, we use vt. Here u is 8, so we are using 8t. Here v is minus 19, so minus 19t. Instead of gamma, we'll use wt. So instead of w, we can use wt, that is minus 2t. And instead of d, we are using dt square. So minus 20 t square is equal to 0. After taking the first order partial derivative, we will substitute t is equal to 1 to maintain the homogeneity. So the answer will be 8x minus 19y minus 2z minus 40. And if you substitute 1 minus 2, 3 in this equation, we will get 0. Hence, all the first order partial derivatives of the given equation is equal to 0 at the vertex 1, minus 2, 3. Therefore, the given equation F represents the equation of a cone using the above theorem. Thank you, and we are having one more problem. Now it's your turn to solve this problem. So you have to prove that 2x square minus 7y square plus 2z square minus 10yz minus 8zx minus 10xy plus 6x plus 12y minus 6z minus 3 represents a cone with vertex 1/4, 1/2 and 1/4. So hope you'll get the knowledge and we'll do this one. Meet you in the next class. Thank you.